To enhance your security posture and defenses, it is essential that you have up-to-date knowledge on two key things. In this video created by digitalworldvision.com, learn the online cyber attacks relevant now, emerging cyber risks and attack vectors. Dynamic threats may be overcome by keeping situational vigilance across this terrain of a rapidly changing nature so that your assets are protected at all times. Cyber attacks. Russian APT hackers are attacking critical infrastructure. The report discusses the Russian APT hackers who are involved in targeting critical infrastructure and using different genuine software installations to put their malware into operation. Among these, Shadowpad Rat has been connected with them. Whereas they use a wide range of tactics, such as many backdoors at the same time, to create duplicate communication channels with polluted systems. These comprise well-researched phishing emails, domain controller hijacking, and stealing confidential data that will be stored in servers hosted from various parts of the world. Stolen information is forwarded from CNC servers used in these attacks to stage two servers located in China. A design flaw in the way it warns users about its security has been found by researchers, and a PDF exploit targeting Foxit PDF reader users is now known. Potentially, an attacker can create a malicious code to be executed by deceiving users with default OK options for security warnings. Deviating from traditional security mechanisms, this flaw permits malware authors to trick users into clicking OK without any preference for the threat that will result. This bug allows hackers to download and execute malware on victims' machines once they lure them into visiting websites under their control. Instead of using conventional methods to launch attacks, social engineering is employed to make this exploit less detectable. Different harmful intentions have seen the vulnerability actively exploited in real-world assaults. Attackers launched a campaign in early March 2024, distributing Trojanized installers for WinCP and PuTTY, which led to downloads containing malware. The malware used a renamed python.x that loaded a malicious DLL, which sideloaded a legitimate DLL and injected a sliver beacon using reflective DLL injection. The attackers then established persistence, downloaded additional payloads, attempted to steal data, and deployed ransomware, showing TTPs similar to those used by Black Cat LPV in the past. The ad for PuTTY download redirected users to a typo-squatted domain hosting a malicious download link, and clicking the link triggered a chain of redirects, ultimately downloading a malware-laced zip archive disguised as a PuTTY installer from a compromised WordPress domain. Cryptocurrency thefts and other financial offenses are being carried out by a huge botnet composed of over 400,000 hacked Linux servers, according to the new research from ESET cybersecurity experts. The Ebury criminal group is responsible for organizing this botnet that has been in operation since 2009 with multiple propagation methods, including hijacking hosting providers' infrastructure, as well as ARP spoofing attacks. The network's size has ballooned, and it still had more than 100,000 infected servers till the end of 2023. Apart from traditional spamming and directing traffic to other sites, this botnet also steals financial information and mines cryptocurrencies on infected machines. The latest version of Ebury malware launched in late 2023, update number 1.8 improved its rootkits to be more difficult to find, added a new domain generation algorithm, and made hiding any information better. One of the recently developed Linux backdoors was identified, which was dubbed Linux Gomir. It was created by the North Korean hacker group Springtail and has been frequently attacking users through installation packages. This backdoor acts as GoBear's replica and communicates with its CNC server over HTTP POST, where it first hashes the hostname and username before sending an infection ID. It uses a particular form of encryption to interpret commands, which exhibits the group's ability to attack platforms in different environments. A second alert discovers an evil code in XZUtils versions 5.6.0 and 5.6.1 that introduces a backdoor via SSH into certain Linux distributions, affecting servers accepting incoming SSH connections. Users should downgrade to unaffected versions and check for compromise signs on their systems that are affected by this vulnerability. The XZ-Utils backdoor, found in the open source library XZ-Utils, allows for remote code execution and was planted into the program by one of its developers, who had been engaged in developing it throughout 2 years before being promoted to maintainer's position. The latest releases of XZ-Utils are vulnerable to this backdoor, meaning that downgrading compromised versions is very critical when preventing such attacks. A new acoustic keyboard side channel attack has been found by cybersecurity researchers, which can be utilized by hackers to steal important information by capturing the sounds of keystrokes with the help of microphones. This attack consists of waveform analysis that allows for the extraction of such information as timing and intensity. At this point, statistical analysis, machine learning, and signal processing come into play. The authors suggest a method in which keystroke audio is captured. A statistical model is trained for prediction, and an English dictionary improves results for predicting words even if there is noise. The aim of the research is to make it possible to identify keystrokes without relying on conditions in the environment precisely. It stresses how important it is to record correctly keyboard sounds in order to detect them efficiently. The report discusses the discovery of a zero-day vulnerability in Windows OS, specifically the Windows Desktop Window Manager, or DWM vulnerability, designated as CVE-2024-30051. This vulnerability allows attackers to escalate privileges. The document containing information about this exploit was uploaded to VirusTotal on April 1, 2024. After reporting the findings to Microsoft, a patch was released on May 14, 2024. The exploit has been observed in attacks involving Cackbot and other malware, indicating multiple threat actors have access to it. Cybersecurity analysts at Rapid7 have identified a new social engineering attack that delivers the Black Basta ransomware. The attack begins with a surge of seemingly harmless newsletter sign-up confirmation spam emails that bypass email protections. Attackers then make phone calls pretending to be IT support to persuade users to allow remote access through tools like AnyDesk or Quick Assist. Once connected, the attacker downloads payloads to harvest credentials and maintain persistence, which could ultimately result in ransomware infections, as in previous Black Basta operations. This new social engineering technique emerged towards the end of April 2024 and exploits human psychology and behavior to bypass technical security systems. There is a new campaign targeting AI research institutions in the United States by using the Sugar Gh0 St Remote Access Trojan, or RAT. For instance, UNK_SweetSpectre has been found responsible for this operation, and it has maliciously affected many businesses, government agencies, and universities. This attack involves sending emails with AI-related lures to victims, which include a zip archive file that drops an LNK shortcut file and a JavaScript dropper. It then installs the Sugar Gh0 St RAT code using this dropper. The attack chain is similar to one that was reported previously by Cisco Talos, wherein sideloading ActiveX tools accompanied by base 64 encoded binaries has been employed and a false document has been employed. The timing of this offensive campaign during US-China tension over AI access and its focus on AI professionals may suggest possible motives related to espionage or intellectual property theft. Windows machines are targeted using malicious attachments such as XLSX, HTML, or PDF files in phishing emails. The malware can clone itself and take control of affected accounts with risks such as data loss, fraud, and compromising sensitive information. QuickBooks invoices, which are used to disguise phishing emails from this campaign, make users download JAR files containing obfuscated auto-IT scripts that communicate with remote servers. Darkgate is a major cybersecurity concern as it combines professional malware practices with historical URL patterns, consequently demonstrating advanced persistent threat techniques. Nissan Oceania has confirmed that in December 2023, roughly 100,000 people, including customers and employees, were affected by the data breach. The breach resulted from a third party without permission accessing local IT servers. The Akira ransomware syndicate, however, claims they did it and exposed stolen information. Personal details compromised include government identification such as medical cards, licenses for driving, passports, and tax file numbers, among others, and other personal details like loan documents, employment information, and dates of birth. Affected people are being informed by Nissan, which are also offering such support as free credit monitoring services to these individuals, along with ID replacement reimbursement. The firm is now collaborating with government authorities and cybersecurity experts to investigate this occurrence. There have been instances of Russian-speaking threat actors from the Commonwealth of Independent States, CIS, using GitHub as a platform to host malicious infrastructure and distribute various forms of malware. They make imitation GitHub profiles and repositories that emulate famous software programs, tricking people into downloading pirated versions loaded with malware, such as the Atomic macOS Stealer. Institutions are advised to observe tough security protocols, institute code reviews across their entire organization, and use auto-scanning tools to identify possible malware or suspicious coding patterns. Similarly, organizations should create means through which they can guard against unauthorized applications and third-party scripts being used by outsiders in their systems, while joining hands with the larger cybersecurity community in order to effectively counter these diverse attacks. D-Link RC zero-day vulnerability. A proof-of-concept POC exploit has been publicly released for a remote code execution RCE zero-day vulnerability in D-Link XOAX 4800 DIRX 4860 routers. The vulnerability allows unauthenticated remote attackers to gain elevated privileges and execute commands as root by combining an authentication bypass with command injection. The exploit takes advantage of flaws in the Home Network Administration Protocol, HNAP service, to bypass authentication and inject malicious commands. D-Link has been notified of the issues, but has not released a fix, so users should disable remote management to prevent exploitation. Norway recommends replacing SSL VPN Web VPN. Norway's National Cybersecurity Center, NCSC, recommends replacing SSL VPN Web VPN solutions with more secure alternatives like IPsec with IKEV2 due to repeated vulnerabilities exploited by threat actors. The transition is advised to be completed by 2025, with critical infrastructure organizations urged to adopt safer options by the end of 2024. The move aims to reduce the attack surface for secure remote access incidents and enhance network security against breaches. Apple has terminated 370 million plus developer and customer accounts. Apple recently terminated more than 370 million developer and customer accounts in 2023 to combat fraud and ensure a secure platform for users and developers. This action is part of Apple's ongoing efforts to enhance anti-fraud measures and maintain the integrity of the App Store. The company's strict fraud prevention analysis led to the deletion of millions of accounts and the rejection of fraudulent developer enrollments, demonstrating Apple's commitment to protecting its ecosystem. Tor Browser 13 0.15 released. Tor Browser 13 0.15 has been released, which features vital security updates and flaw fixes. It is the Tor network's anonymous door to Firefox. It routes traffic through a network of volunteer relays to hide a user's location and usage from anyone performing network surveillance or traffic analysis. The browser is available for Windows, macOS, Linux, and Android, and is localized in 37 languages. Users can then customize their privacy and security settings accordingly among three possible levels of protection, like standard, safer, or safest. This video was created by digitalworldvision.com.